Ward. She is the executive director of the Pennsylvania Budget and Policy Center. Sharon, thank you for being with us.
Thanks for having me, Brian.
What is your organization's position on this bill?
Well, we're opposed to Senate Bill 76. We believe that property taxes have paid for public schools in Pennsylvania for 150 years for good reason. They're stable. They allow local communities to have a say in spending and allocation of dollars. And schools are very important to Pennsylvania's communities and to our economy. And we're concerned that Senate Bill 76 really takes a big bite out of public education, which is going to hurt our kids and our economy moving forward.
Let's get each of the senators comment on your comment, and then you can have the last word.
Yeah. I'm trying to help public education. My father, my grandfather, both taught in the public schools, as did my mom. Both my kids have graduated and done exceedingly well with a public school education. But I just can't defend the status quo, and quite honestly, I can't imagine that anybody can do that with a straight face. I think that the current system is incredibly unfair, and when I'm looking at poll numbers, the running Eagle 2 years ago, people called in 90-6 in favor of this plan. KQV radio in Pittsburgh, 74% in favor. The York Dispatch, 73% in favor. I really think that this is an idea whose time has come, and this special interest kaleidoscope that's against it, I think I said it last week, I think these groups that are opposing it are on the wrong side of history.
Sharon Ward, are you defending the status quo?
Well, look, I think that I disagree with Senator Argall in one respect and agree with him in a different respect. The first is that property taxes are not uniformly high across Pennsylvania. They're high in Senator Argall's district and they're high in Senator Udichek's district. We've looked very carefully at property taxes across the state. There are 30 districts out of 500 where property taxes are high compared to people's ability to pay for them. You know, in contrast, there are 129 districts where property taxes are actually very low. So this is not a problem that everyone is clamoring about across the state. It doesn't require destroying the public education system. What it requires is a targeted solution to those communities and those individuals that can't afford property taxes. Where I agree is that we are relying too much on property taxes, and that's because the state is not paying the appropriate share of school funding. In most states, 50% of school funding comes from the state, and only 36% from the local property taxpayers. We're the opposite in Pennsylvania. So that is a problem that we have to fix. And I don't think that completely destroying the public education system is the appropriate way to go. But there are better solutions.
Senator Udichek?
I agree with Sharon. The state needs to pay more. The state needs to invest more in education. And this is the vehicle to put the state on that level. It's a way to make the state more responsible. I think the system that we have where Harrisburg can say, let the locals raise the taxes, let them raise the revenue. And to the point of stability, I look to my district, Luzerne and Carbon counties, where the mines have closed, the factories have closed, we have the highest unemployment rate for 48 straight months. The schools cannot raise the revenue. I have one school district right now that is currently going through a labor dispute. They were hit, devastated by the floods of 2011. They've lost homes. They've lost businesses. So their property tax base is eroded. Where are those schools going to raise money to adequately fund those schools? We are putting all of that burden on the homeowner, all that burden on the property taxes. Senate Bill 76 is a way for the state to get fully engaged, get up where they are making the proper investment in our schools. I that's where I fundamentally disagree with Sharon. We should be investing more in schools, and Senate Bill 76 is a creative way to get to that.
Sharon Ward, final comments?
Oh, I just say that the bill, the way it's drafted now, actually really caps school funding so that the crisis that we're seeing in our school districts where programs are closing, too many kids in a class, music, arts, sports, all being eliminated, Senate Bill 76 will make those problems permanent in Pennsylvania. And I think that's moving in the wrong direction, particularly when there are better options. We don't have to go that far. We can have well-funded public schools, and also find targeted property tax relief for struggling homeowners.
Sharon Ward, Executive Director of the Pennsylvania Budget and Policy Center, thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks very much, Brian.
Second of the call, Bill from Chambersburg, you're on the air.
Good afternoon, or good evening, gentlemen. How are you?
Good.
My concern is just being a newly Pennsylvania resident since 2010, and when I bought my house, I had questioned the school property tax of being legitimate. And nobody really knew why. It was just there. Nobody questioned it. And then all of a sudden, it started picking up traction. Upon my further reviews and just digging into this, and I picked up the Pennsylvania Constitution and read Article 8, Section 1, where it says that all taxes shall be uniform within the same class of subjects. And just reviewing that little snippet just tells me that it's the uniformity of this tax is being founded on the homeowner's responsibility. I've actually had conversations with the Pennsylvania Department of Education Chief Counsel. I've had thorough discussions and emails that identify that he had told me that the Pennsylvania Department of Education did not have the authority to tax. And reading some of these articles that I've seen in the paper, that some of these counties have asked permission for the Pennsylvania Department of Education to give their overall approval to tax. To me, that's basically a division within their chain of command to identify that one administrative agency, the Pennsylvania Department of Education, cannot tax, but give their local schools authority to tax just homeowners. And the way this is basically said is homeowners have an invisible lien on their properties owned by the school districts. And to the betterment of my knowledge, that no government entity can own or possess private property for revenue or profit. And further review of SB 76, I do agree it should be passed without any hesitation. Let's just put that forward there.
Okay, let's let you go.
There's a lot in the Constitution that it talks about we should have a thorough and efficient system of public education. You know, the system that Sharon is defending right now, some school districts get 15% of their funding from the state. Some school districts get 50, 60, 70%. I just can't imagine that anyone can defend the status quo. And quite honestly, what the property tax elimination groups have told us is that if Senate Bill 76 doesn't pass, they're going to the Supreme Court. We just can't imagine how the justices would ever allow this system to continue. And these defenders of the status quo, if I tried to make that argument back in my district, I'd get fired.
Now, there was a report from the state's independent fiscal office that found that staying with property taxes would generate $2.6 billion more than your bill by fiscal 2018-19. How do you address that gap?
It would produce more because the property taxes would continue to go up. That's the problem we're trying to solve.
But if they don't